The concept of cost is a key concept in economics. It refers to the amount of payment made to acquire any goods and services. The concept of cost gives an indication of the overall resources required to avail the same. So today, in our video, we are going to understand types of cost in economics in detail with different examples. Following types of cost I had included in my video. Number 1. Real cost. It refers to the payment made to compensate for all those effort and sacrifices undergone by various members in production of a commodity. Real costs are also termed as social cost because the society faces a number of difficulties during the production process. For example, real costs are the exertion of all the different type of labor that are directly or indirectly involved in making of movie. Number 2. Money cost. Money cost is also known as the nominal cost. It is nothing but the expenses incurred by a firm to produce a commodity. For instance, the cost of producing 200 chair is rupees 10,000 and then it will be called the money cost of producing 200 chairs. Number 3. Opportunity cost. Opportunity cost represents the potential benefit that an individual, investor or businesses misses out on when choosing one alternative over another. More simply, it means if you choose one activity, for example an investment, you are giving up the opportunity to do a different option. For example, a student spent $3 and $20 at the movie the night before an exam. The opportunity cost is time spent studying and that money to spend on something else. Number 4. Total cost. Total cost is the minimum cost of producing some quantity of output. This is the total economic cost of production and is made up of variable cost, which varies according to the quantity of a good produced and includes inputs such as labor and raw material plus fixed cost, which is independent of the quantity of a good produced and includes inputs that cannot be varied in the short run, such as building and machinery, including possibly sunk cost. For example, if a firm has a fixed cost of producing bags for $30 per unit and a variable cost is $5 per unit as they increase their output, the total cost will be $35. Number 5. Fixed cost. The cost which don't vary with changing output. Fixed cost might include the cost of building a factory, insurance and legal bills. Even if your output changes or you don't produce anything, your fixed costs stay the same. They tend to be recurring, such as interest or rent being paid per month. For example, a bakery must pay rent and utility bill irrespective of how much bread is produced and sold. Number 6. Average fixed cost. The average fixed cost is the fixed cost that does not change with the change in the number of goods and services produced by a company. To put it in a nutshell, the average fixed cost is the fixed cost per unit and is calculated by dividing the total fixed cost by the output level. Since no cost is fixed for a long time, the average fixed cost is only for a short run. When the unit of production increases, the average fixed cost per unit decreases. Similarly, when the business produces less unit, the average cost increases per unit. For example, if the fixed cost of a pen factory is $5,000 and it produces 500 pen, then the average fixed price will be $10 per unit. Number 7. Variable cost. A variable cost is a corporate expense that changes in proportion to how much a company produces or sells. Variable costs increase or decrease depending on a company's production or sales volume. They rise as production increases and falls as production decreases. For example, if you produce more cars, you have to use more raw materials such as metal and vice versa. Number 8. Average cost. Average cost refers to the per unit cost of production, which is calculated by dividing the total cost of production by the total numbers of units produced. In other words, it measures the amount of money that the business has to spend to produce each unit of output. For example, since the total cost of producing 40 haircuts at the clip joint is $320, the average cost for producing each of 40 haircut is $320 divided by 40, that is $8 per haircut. Number 9. Marginal cost. Marginal cost is the cost of producing an extra unit. In economics, the marginal cost is the change in the total cost that arises when the quantity produced is incremented. That is, the cost of producing additional quantity. For example, if the total cost of 3 units is $1,500 and the total cost of 4 units is $1,900, the marginal cost of the 4th unit is $1,900 minus $1,500, that is $300. Number 10. Semi-variable cost. It is a cost composed of a mixture of both fixed and variable components. Costs are fixed for a set level of production or consumption, and they become variable after this production level is exceeded. If no production occurs, a fixed cost is often still incurred. For example, labor might be a semi-variable cost. If you produce more cars, you need to employ more workers. That is a variable cost. However, even if you don't produce any car, you may still need some worker to look after an empty factory. Number 11. Sunk cost. These are costs that have been incurred and cannot be recouped. If you left the industry, you could not reclaim sunk cost. A sunk cost, sometimes called a retrospective cost, refers to an investment already incurred that can't be recovered. Examples of sunk cost in business include marketing, research, new software installation or equipment, salaries and benefits, etc. For example, if you spend money on advertising to enter an industry, you can never claim those costs back. But if you buy a machine, you might be able to sell if you leave the industry. Number 12. Avoidable cost. Cost that can be avoided. An avoidable cost is an expense that will not be incurred if a particular activity is not performed. Avoidable cost refer primarily to variable cost that can be removed from a business operation, unlike most fixed cost which must be paid regardless of the activity level of a company. For example, if you stop producing cars, you don't have to pay for extra raw materials and electricity. Number 13. Explicit cost. These are costs that a firm directly pays for and can be seen on the accounting sheet. Explicit cost can be variable or fixed, just as a clear amount. Explicit cost is a payment made to others while running a business that represent cash outflow. It includes wages, mortgage, rent, utilities, advertisements, raw materials, and other general administrative and sales cost. For example, a company that hires 3 new professionals pays an explicit cost of their salaries, which it can track on the general ledger. Number 14. Implicit cost. These are opportunity costs which do not necessarily appear on its balance sheet, but affect the firm. Implicit costs aren't often monetary values a company can easily track. This means that they don't appear on the general ledger. Many implicit costs are the opportunity cost of deciding on one action over another. For example, if a firm uses its asset, like a printing press, to print leaflet for a charity, it means that it loses out on revenue from producing commercial leaflets. So friends, these are total types of cost included in my video. Thanks for watching.